Hi guys, welcome along to another video on Meadow Grove Farm. Today it's just going to be another small little video, really, like the last one. Just do bits and bobs around the farm. Ground's too cold at the minute, ground's frosted to do any work, so we're stuck to just minimal stuff, really. So what we're doing today is we're just going to get all the cows nice and cleaned up, bedded up, fed up, and yeah, we're probably going to do a little bit of well, I'm gonna buy a chainsaw and I'm gonna buy the log bits for the Johnston's trailer as well, so we can do a little bit of forestry while we're waiting for things to come good on the, regarding to the soil. So yeah, we can keep busy, I suppose. It's not going to be a long video logging. I'll probably just do a little time lapse of us doing it. Just be interesting to see how much money we make from it, to be honest. We'll probably get one trailer load full, see how much we get from it, and yeah, it might be another little income for winter time, which would be good. We're in on the second day of winter, so yeah, got all the muck took out to the fields that we wanted the muck at, so they're ready to go. We just can't get any muck spreading done either because the frosty ground, which I thought was a bit weird. I thought you could still spread muck when the ground's cold. Obviously it just doesn't go down into the ground until it's thawed out a bit, but hey ho, that doesn't matter. So yeah, I never really do videos on us actually sorting the animals out and bits and bobs like that, so I thought for a change it might be nice. It's always nice to see something a bit different, I guess. It's gonna go in there nicely. There we go. Brilliant. So yeah, we've just got the straw to do, and the TMR to do as well, and the ration. So, and we got a muck from out as well. I forgot about that. But yeah, they're producing a nice amount of muck as well, to be honest, which I'm glad about because we need plenty of it so we can keep putting it on the fields and stuff. We have got the slurry as well, to be fair. We've got 300 odd thousand of that, so we can always lease a tanker and get some of that done. If it gets to a point where the manure's getting low though, what I'll do is just keep that for stubble the crop fields and then just get a slurry on the grass fields. Don't think it makes much difference, but or whatever, it doesn't really matter. It's all going to do the same job. Just it's got a lot longer to sink into the crop fields rather than the grass. If it doesn't have long enough, then you can, well, not in the game, but you can pick it up with when you cut, mow the grass and pick it up. Right, let's get this muck out. We're sustaining a bit of a pile. I mean, we have chewed into it quite a lot, as you can tell. that's a bit close. Yeah, we're definitely getting it down a bit. Not good. But yeah, all the cows seem to have settled in nicely. All seem happy, all feeding. So, nothing to complain about. For this last little bit. The other thing I'm probably going to buy as well is a log fork for the telehandler, just to make it a lot easier for loading it onto the trailer. Really? Right, let's get this dumped off over here, and then I'll sort us out a the log holder, I don't know what it is, it's whatever you pick the logs up with, log fork, you know, log grab, I suppose, something like that. Right, so yeah, I'll catch up with you in a sec. Right, there we have it, first full load, all the logs done, not looking bad. I just realised that for about past 20 minutes the recorder's not recorded any of the gameplay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to come back, cut a few more trees down, and we'll get a bit more of a gameplay out of it. I wonder how many trees we did cut though. 1, 2, 3, 4 7, I think, 8, yeah, so not too bad to be fair, 8 trees, got that much. It's going to be nice to see how much they're going to be worth. So what we'll do is we'll head up to the sawmill, see how much we get for them. Lucky that's not rubbing on there, isn't it? Didn't take that long either, to be honest. Took about 10 minutes with that loader to get all the trees on. It's probably the smoothest I've ever done forestry. Like every other time I've tried it, it's been an absolute nightmare. Been messing about with stuff for ages, and yeah, that was actually really smooth. Went well. And trust it to have not caught the video. The actual game capture, which is a bit annoying, but yeah, it happens sometimes. I'm just glad I realised now, halfway through the video, than when I came to edit it, because that would have been even worse. Right, I'll catch you in a minute when we get to the sawmill. Right, here we are. I've just got to open this gate quickly. It's where that yellow marker is over there, so let's just head towards that first off. Oh, we've got plenty of room. I think we'll back into it first just to make sure we get them in the right spot. You go to the trigger and press R or something to sell. Right, I might be because I'm just parked right on it. strap those on it before we make them fall off. Right, stop there. Let's have a go there, shall we? Right, here we go. I had to put the zone markers on. These little markers on the floor to see where I'd have to go, so it reckons here. Let's give it a go. Nice. I'm 36 grand. I'm happy with that. Right, let's go do another load quickly then. I'll do one more load. Like I said, I was gonna just do one, but because of the video, didn't pick it up. I'll do another. So, and then we'll probably do in the winter. We'll do a loader episode. So, but yeah. Right, I'll catch you in a minute. Here we are back in the forest. I can't believe that this came with the with our land. It's real handy. There's quite a lot of it as well. So. Yeah, I think we'll probably start taking out that middle section there, because that looks like a good place for where a corn dryer could go, so we'll start there. We'll do another 8 trees, I think. See how that goes. See if we can get another full load. It's not the way I wanted it to fall. But, oh well. Let's see if we could do it this way and it falls the opposite. It's a shame you can't cut chunks out of it. It's a bit annoying, but there we go. Three. Four. I can't believe we got 39 grand for that. That was good. Really good.
I wanna know your secrets. I wanna be your lifeline. So I wait for you, wait for me. Wait for you, wait for me. Tell me you're more than just a highlight. Pretty pictures on the outside. I hate to stare at you through these lights. So I wait for you, wait for me. Wait for you, wait for me. Click and scroll, I can't let you go. They say I'm addicted to you. Click and scroll, I can't let you go. They say I'm addicted to you. Oh, oh. This ain't love, no, no. This ain't love, no, no. This is artificial.
Losing your winning,
right guys, there's the last load. Not as tidy as the first one, but I've got a sneaky suspicion we're probably going to get more for this. I think it was 8 trees we still cut down, but I think they must have just been better. Bigger and better trees. So yeah. It's definitely heavier. It's stacked quite high, so I'm gonna have to take this journey steady. So yeah, I'll meet you at the shop, find out how much it is, and then that'll be it for today, I think. Here we are, back at the sawmill. I genuinely can't believe how much we made out of that first load. I think it was like 39 grand or something. 40 grand. It's going to be interesting to see how much we make out of this one. I do feel like we're going to get more. But yeah, this could be very handy what we've got ourselves here. 34,000. Wow. It's put us up to 128,000. I mean, if we can do that every episode in the winter, because I think that's when it's worth more, we're going to be laughing really. So yeah, what a good note to end on. Alright guys, I'll see you again in the next one. Bye for now.